Merry Christmas, everyone, and welcome to Washington National Cathedral. My name is Thomas Sheehan. I'm the organist and associate director of music here at Washington Cathedral, and thank you so much for coming to our organ recital, our Christmas organ recital, which is back in person for the first time in a few years. We took 2 years of doing this event recorded only, which was a real shame, but I am so glad to see not just people back in person, but lots of people back in person. So this is fantastic. So thank you so much for coming. Good afternoon, Merry Christmas again. You're going to hear a varied program today of organ music from myself and my colleague who's back at the organ console right now, Rebecca Ehren, organ scholar here. And she will be beginning the program first with a piece called A Christmas Fantasy by Jonathan Scott. After that, we will be hearing Noël Étranger by Louis-Claude Daquin, who was an 18th century, 17th and 18th century composer of particularly famous Christmas music in Paris at the time. A Christmas Fantasy, which you'll be hearing first by Jonathan Scott, is a medley of very familiar and popular Christmas tunes that you'll all recognize, I'm sure. Jonathan Scott has made his name recently, within the past few years, as a YouTube sensation on the organ. He lives in England, has been recording a lot of videos all around the British Isles, and also in Taiwan as well. Really impressive musician, and he releases a Christmas video each year. This piece is from one of those Christmas videos. A Christmas Fantasy by Jonathan Scott. Thank you again for coming, and Merry Christmas.
Thank you. everyone, and welcome. Thank you so much for being here today, and Merry Christmas. It's so great to see everyone here in person. My name is Rebecca Ehren, and as my colleague Tom mentioned, I am the organ scholar here at the National Cathedral. And what a thrill it's been to celebrate Christmas here for the past 24 hours and before that even. We have quite a program lined up for you. As you've heard, this is sort of one of the most fun organ recitals I perhaps have been a part of. It's essentially a bunch of Christmas tunes and a few other things thrown in. And next up, I'll be playing two pieces, one of which is another sort of medley of Christmas tunes, and the second is also a sort of parade of wooden soldiers. And I think it'll be obvious from the way the organ sounds, the sort of march-like qualities. The next two pieces I'll play, they illustrate the way the organ can sound like a whole orchestra with all sorts of different sounds, from strings to bells to trumpets and everything in between. So first up will be Parade of the Wooden Soldiers, and then I'll play Richard Purvis's Carol Rhapsody, which is just what it sounds like, a rhapsody full of your favorite Christmas carols.
Thank you again for coming. And we've reached the portion of the performance where we will now be passing some plates around. Please be as generous as you are able to be. This program that we run here does take a substantial amount of funding, so your generosity is extremely appreciated. If you'd like to give online instead of in person, you'd be most welcome to visit cathedral.org/musicgiving. That will be the location for that. While the plates are coming around, we thought we would do a little demonstration of some of the sounds of the organ. You've already heard a bunch of them, but some of them on their own. So, Rebecca, if we could please have a demonstration of some of the principal sounds of the organ first. These are not imitative of any other orchestral instrument, and they are sort of the backbone sound of the organ. So these are the principals on their own. Very sort of stately and forthright sound, as I said, not imitative of anything else. Pure organ tone. The second thing we'll hear is the flutes of the organ. If we could have a few of the different ones, that would be lovely. Flute pipes are just like principal pipes, except they're wider. When you make them wider, their tone gets a little bit more gentle and a little bit darker and less piercing, and it starts to sound a little bit like the flutes of the orchestra. As I said, very, very beautiful, very gentle. The third family of organ sound out of four that we're going to hear eventually is what we call the strings. These are sort of the opposite of the flutes in some way. The pipes are very narrow, and when you make those pipes very narrow, they become very bright in sound and almost a little scratchy. And on their own, they don't sound like string instruments, but when you put many of them together, there's a chorusing effect. They reinforce each other's sound, and we get this kind of carpet of sound that you've already heard a little bit in this recital, but here it is again. It's almost hard to believe that sound comes from pipes with air moving through them. It's almost like a modern synthesizer sound or something. This organ has particularly beautiful strings, and in this acoustic, they work really well and make this marvelous, magical, kind of ethereal sound. The last of the families of organ sound, the fourth, is the reeds. Reeds are so called because there's actually a moving part within them. The other pipes only have air moving through them, but these have a very thin sheet of metal that vibrates inside the air stream and makes a more powerful sound. So if we could hear some of the reeds next. Fantastic. Sounds like trumpets, not actually like a windblown trumpet at all, like the trumpet in an orchestra, but made with this very, very high pressure air moving past a brass reed. So those are the four different kinds of pipes. There are just over 10,000 pipes inside this organ. They're all up above behind these archways, and it takes up the whole of the great choir, basically. There's so many of them. So. They range in size from extremely small to extremely large. So if we could hear some of the smallest pipes on their own first, these would probably belong to some of the mixture stops. The highest pipes there are only about the length of, just a few inches long, actually, and they're very narrow indeed. And then, there's a picture of them on the screens right now. Perfect. So. The longest pipes in the organ are up above. They're lying on their side, actually, and they're just over 30 feet long. So let's hear a little bit of those. It doesn't sound like much on its own, except maybe a truck idling outside. But underneath the full organ sound, that it makes an amazing timpani roll sort of effect. So this organ is incredible, and we love it dearly, but it is in pretty terrible mechanical shape, actually. So it's had a number of problems over the years, and we can have one really good demonstration of that if we have the screen go over to the console, and Rebecca will play some of the notes on our trumpet en chemade solo stop. Watch closely. Last one goes the wrong direction, there's a bunch missing in the middle. So there's a problem all over the organ like that. It's mostly due to water damage, but also it's just an aging piece of machinery. So again, your generosity is appreciated. It's very expensive to maintain a piece of equipment like this. So again, thank you for coming. The next piece will be variations on From Heaven Above, From Earth to Earth I Come by Walter Peltz. This piece is based on a Renaissance-era German hymn called Vom Himmel Hoch. The different variations of this piece all represent the different verses. So if you have the printed program, look on the back of it, you'll see all of the printed verses there. And if you follow along with each variation, you'll notice that Walter has given us a really great representation of each verse along the way. So that's some entertainment for you.
Wow. Well, after that sort of tour de force, you may have noticed my attire has changed slightly. Now is kind of the fun, silly part of the program, where Tom and I will actually be playing together. Two organists, eight limbs. And we'll be playing a couple of holiday favorites. First up, Leroy Anderson's Sleigh Ride. And of course, that has been, I'm sure you'll probably recognize it. Numerous orchestras and bands play that every holiday season as quite a favorite with all sorts of wacky noises. We really put the organ to use. And then the Hallelujah Chorus, I think, needs no explanation. So we will play a rendition of that on the organ as well. So once again, thank you all for coming. It is so fabulous to see so many of you here. And thank you to all of our viewers online as well. It's such a pleasure to have everyone here to join us for this sort of glorious Christmas afternoon. So without further ado, Leroy Anderson's Sleigh Ride, followed by the Hallelujah Chorus.